Okay, so right now we are discussing the numbers between 0 and 1 and what kind of properties do they exhibit. Okay, so let me start off with drawing a number line. Okay, we're going to draw a small number line over here and we're going to see what numbers we are actually discussing. Okay, so if this is 0 and we have 1 and further off we have 2, below 0 we have negative 1 and further off we have negative 2. Now, what we are going to be discussing are the properties of the numbers that are lying between 0 and 1, basically this part. Now, this can actually be 0.5, the numbers can be like 0.25 or 0.33547 or anything like that, okay? So any number along along this region, okay? This is what we're going to be discussing, and what are the properties that they exhibit, and what are the rules that we can apply on each and every single one of these numbers, which lie between 0 and 1. So the general way of writing all of this is by saying that the number, the variable we're going to be writing x, is actually less than 0, greater than 0, and less than 1. X is greater than 0, that is why the alligator's mouth is towards x, and 1 is greater than x. Okay, so generally this is what we're going to be discussing, and for specific terms we're going to be using the number 0.2 0.5. Okay, and so first of all, let's say that if we have the number, if we have like if we do this, we have this side and we have this side. A is any positive number, and A will be equal to 2 when we're going to be discussing in the more precise way to see if it is true or not. Now, what is this saying? This is saying that if you multiply a number, any positive number, with the numbers between 0 and 1, what you get is that these numbers are less, the what we find over here, the product of these two numbers is less than the number itself. Now that is pretty weird, but let's see if this is true. Now we're going to be using the specific terms that we have denoted for both of them, and we're going to see if this is actually true. Now we're not going to be putting any sign over here because we don't know which side is greater. Now 0.5 can also be written as 1 over 2 in the fraction form. Let's see, 2 by 2 is cancelled, so we are left with 1 as, and over here we have 2. So this actually is true. If you multiply any number between 0 and 1 with another positive number, what you get is that this whole side is going to be less than the actual number itself. Now, this is one of the properties exhibited by these special numbers, the numbers between 0 and 1. Over to the next property we are going to be discussing. This is the last property we are going to be discussing. Now, the same thing, the number we are going to be using, exactly 0.5 for the more specific terms, and we are going to be become familiar with these numbers. Okay, so m is greater than n and n is greater than 1. Specifically, we're going to be using these terms. N is like 2 and m is 3. Okay, so over to what is the property. Now, if x is raised to the power m and x is raised to the power n and 1, these x raised to the power m is less than x raised to the power n, and x raised to the power n is less than 1. Now, how can that actually be true? Now, let's actually see if it is true. Okay, so 1 by 2, that is x, 0.5, and m, okay, we have 3, and x exactly half, and we have n, which is 2, raised to the power 2 squared, cubed, and we have 1. Let's see if this inequality actually holds. Exactly, not going to be putting any inequality signs right now. Now, one cubed, okay, it is one, and two cubed is two times two times two. That is two twos are four, and four times two is eight. Now, two squared is four, and one squared is always one. Now, as you can see, the inequality actually does hold true. 1 by 4 is greater than 1 by 8, and 1 is actually greater than 1 by 4.